I have received confirmation more than 20 people, I think. So now I start my lecture for today. And as you all know that we have started a series of video lectures for paper one and paper two. And this is different for different streams. And we have already gone through from the presentation and lecture for paper one, five subjects, okay? So in continuation of that series, in this lecture, I shall talk about all the subjects which were left in that presentation, okay? So now I shall talk about those subjects and I shall tell you how to study that and what should be your plan. And this should be the last lecture, last introduction lecture for paper one. And after that, we shall start some of the actual chapters from paper one, okay? So that our regular video classes series starts. So now I'm sharing my screen so that each and everyone can see what I have written in my slides and I can teach you properly. So now in this presentation, one by one, I shall explain you each and everything necessary for paper one subjects. So first of all, let me tell you that this presentation is part two of introductory lecture on paper one preparation and subject strategies. I have already delivered the part one on Wednesday, and I talked about first five subjects of paper one. Okay, we have already talked about how I told you how to make their preparation good and what to study, what to leave, what you can skip, and how much is the proportion of a particular subject and particular topic. So in this lecture, I shall talk about the subjects which we left in that video. So again, I would like to tell you that the weightage of this particular paper is 100 marks. And this particular syllabus of paper one covers a total of 10 subjects. And from each subject, 10 questions shall be asked. And each question is of 2 marks. So each and every subject contains a total of 20 marks. Some of the subjects are very high scoring, in which you can expect more than 16 or 18 marks even. And some you have to skip, because whatever the books you go through, I'm sure that getting 20 marks from some of the subjects is a very difficult job. And so you are not supposed to waste your time to study the very irrelevant thing which are never asked in the examination, okay? So now I start teaching aptitude. We have already discussed the research. We have discussed then communication. We have already discussed comprehension. I again wish to tell you that just download the application The Hindu or any newspaper, and one editorial is highly preferred on daily basis. If you go through from one editorial of The Hindu newspaper, then I am certainly sure that your at least four questions can be made right. Sorry, I told 10 questions are asked. Just 5 questions are asked from each subject and their weightage is 2 marks. So total of 10 marks paper is depicted from a particular subject of paper one. Okay. So from comprehension, you can expect your 4 questions to be made right if you study just one editorial of The Hindu newspaper. Why I prefer The Hindu? The only thing is that the grammar and the vocabulary used in this newspaper is very worthy. And this is very helpful for the preparation of just a comprehension part of a paper one syllabus. And in mathematical reasoning, we have already gone through, and I suggested you the book of R.S. Agarwal only, and none of the other publisher you can rely upon. Okay, so now we shall talk about the next subjects. This is logical reasoning, first of all, then data interpretation, very high scoring. 10 out of 10 are expected from this part, okay? And this is a very easy, let me tell you, this is very easy again, okay? Logical reasoning, 8 marks can be got, okay? if your preparation is up to mark, then from information and communication technology, you can get eight marks. This is also a very high scoring. I will tell you the strategy of how to go through from the subject of information and communication technology. Then from people development and environment, your 3 to 4 questions will be made right only, okay? Because its syllabus is very, very vast from all the modules. These two modules are having the very vast syllabus, so that's why you can never cover it, because one or two questions from each of these modules shall be asked in a way that you can never get to know from which part these has been asked, okay? So that's why what you should do, you should simply follow whatever the instruction I give you in this particular lecture, okay? So now I start with the sixth module or the sixth part. This is logical reasoning. Before started, I must prefer the book of R.S. Agarwal again. Okay, for when you purchase the book of R.S. Agarwal, your three modules are certainly going to be covered. Okay, the first one is mathematical reasoning. This is fifth one. And the second one is logical reasoning. And the seventh one is data interpretation. Okay, these modules are going to be covered if you purchase this specific book and purchase the full-fledged version. Okay, so now I tell you what to do. This part has been added into the syllabus of UGC NET JRF examination from 2019 June. Okay, this was added from 2019 June, and number of things were added new, and the number of times I have experienced that from 2019 June, there have been written some of the topics from which the questions have never been asked. So you are not supposed to waste your time, and you should not be worried about those parts. Okay, let me tell you which one. The first argument form, this is very important. Okay, some two statements shall be given to you. Statement one, statement two. You have to decipher the argument forms and you have to make the structure. Okay, and you have to find the real one. Which statement is the right one? This kind of a question shall be asked you in the examination. Then from this part, you can go through just one reading, because I am certainly sure that from the past two or three papers, we are not sure what kind of questions are being posted. But I will tell you from where you have to go through from these things, okay? Because a practical aspect is never asked in the examination. Then after that, here is evaluating and deductive and inductive reasoning. This is a very important part. One question shall certainly be asked. And then Venn diagram is there, okay? So one thing I must prefer to you, that you have to go through from the chapter of syllogism. Okay, syllogism covers a lot of a part of this syllabus. This topic and the previous one, this topic shall be covered if you go through from just one chapter. This is syllogism. Okay, this is covered under the logical reasoning. There are number of YouTube videos available for this chapter, but I do not prefer you to go to YouTube. The thing is, people tell you the shortcuts. You are not supposed to believe, because I have experienced that questions are posted in a way that if your basic concepts are clear, only then you shall be able to answer the questions. Otherwise, none kind of shortcuts shall work. Okay. Then Venn diagram, very important topic. This is also a part of syllogism. Okay. Then Indian logics, you can skip it. Then these are also covered in the syllabus, like inferences and comparison, also the part of syllogism. Syllogism is a very, very vast topic. Okay. So these are the things. You are not supposed to be worried about these things. These has been written in Hindi, like pramans, then upmana, then shabda. Okay, let me tell you how to go through. Only one book is to be referred, and this thing is to be gone through. Okay, and specifically Venn diagram. Although this is a separate chapter, but this chapter is also a part of syllogism itself. So you have to go through from this. Okay, these things you can skip out, because I have seen that very low probability is there that the question shall be asked. But these kind of things like inferences and implications, these have been asked from the part of deductive and inductive reasoning. you must go through. You can search from that particular book where these topics have been given. If you go through from these topics, your that part shall be covered. Although one question is to be asked, but I never expect your all questions can be right in the logical reasoning, because nowadays they put some questions in a way that even like these are vipati. These topics are very new to us. Even from the Bachelor of Education books I have gone through, these cannot be found out. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to study only these English parts. Okay, then deductive and inductive, and last the abductive reasoning part would be much more enough for covering all these parts. Okay, so now I have given you information regarding the logical reasoning. Only your four questions, if you have consistently studied this particular subject, only four questions are expected to be made right. Okay, you can fifth one you can assume that that shall be right. So that's why you are not supposed to wait your time for finding these kind of things like vyapti, okay, then upmana, okay, then pramans, okay, then arthapati. So these kind of things you are not supposed to waste your time. Just go through from the deductive, then inductive, then abductive reasoning, after that syllogism, then Venn diagram. Okay, certainly your four questions can be made right. After that there is data interpretation. Yes, I must tell you that 10 out of 10 marks are highly expected from this particular portion. You can make these right. You have to regular practice these. And these are asked in a rotation basis. Okay. From the first particular topic, none kind of a question shall be asked, because already this has been covered in the subject of research aptitude. And that was the second subject in the paper one syllabus. Then these kind of questions shall be asked. You shall be given a bar chart or pie chart or a table chart or a histogram. Okay. A table shall be given to you. It shall contain some data, and five questions shall be asked on the basis of this particular table. And this table can be of any form. This can be of a bar chart. This can be of a pie chart. This can be of a table chart, histogram. Then it can be line chart. Then it can be a mapped data. Okay. So it shall be given to you. If you are mathematically very sound, if you have gone through from that particular book, this book also contains the questions regarding data interpretation. Okay. So this is the first source, and the second source is from 2004 to 2020. You must solve all the previous question in online format. Then your knowledge shall reach to the level that you can easily make at least four questions right from this portion. Otherwise, you have to practice a lot. You have to refer number of mathematical books. Okay. To our students, who have joined our regular group or the course, they are not supposed to be worried about, because each and everything shall be provided to you. Okay. Then you can skip this part, data and governance. None kind of question shall be asked from this part. Data interpretation is the same as the name of the subject. Okay. So what you have to go through, you have to have the understanding of different kind of diagrams. These are bar chart, then pie chart, then table chart, histogram, and then line chart, and mapping of data. Okay. So I have given you information regarding data interpretation. Information and communication technology, highly expected 10 marks are there. Okay, you can make all your questions right. Okay, going through from the subject of information and communication technology is very easy. How? You have to go through from the glossary of all the items relating to ICT, that is information and communication technology. If you go through from this part, then a number of things should be clear to you, and you can make your three or four questions right. Okay. Otherwise, individually from ICT, yes, one question is highly expected. From basics of internet, one question is highly expected. Then intranet and email. Email is a very important topic. Okay. Very important. A number of times a question from email is asked, like what is BCC? Okay. What is C, what is BCC, these kind of terms, or what is subject in the email, these kind of terms are asked in the examination. Then digital initiative in higher education, this is also a very important topic. One question is highly expected. then ICT and governance. It contains the role of a government in the field of ICT. This is information and communication technology. This kind of a question can be asked in the examination. Okay. So now we move further. Let me tell you, the syllabus of this is not that much large. So you should devote much of your time for reading the glossary of ICT rather than reading about these kind of things. Okay. These arthapati, anuplabdhi or structure. Because whatever you go through, you shall always be in doubt whether I have the knowledge or not. But if you go through from the glossary of ICT, it shall make you confident enough that even if my questions from that part or that logical reasoning is wrong, I am sound enough in ICT. Okay, this should be your strategy. After that, this is people development and environment. Whatever you study, you cannot go beyond 3 or 4 questions because its syllabus is very large, very vast. Okay, let me tell you what to study. Millennium development and then sustainable development goals. These were goals by the respective governments. Okay, so they can ask you what kind of goals are being set by the government right now or in the history. That kind of question can be asked to you. One question is highly expected. Okay, then you can skip this part. Okay, impacts on environment. Just one reading should be enough for you for going through from this particular topic. Okay, then environmental issues, local, regional and global, one reading would be enough. Okay, then from this part, air pollution, water pollution and then soil pollution. In our regular test series, number of time the question from this part has been asked. This is very important and one question is highly expected. Then from waste also one question is highly expected. You can never miss that topic. Okay, then climate change, socio-economic, political dimensions. Okay, Environment Protection Act, you have to go through from this particular act, and sometime it's the question is put from this Environmental Protection Act specifically. Okay, then from natural and energy sources, these are the sources, and this topic is very, although this is very vast, but this is very important as well. One question is 100% going to be put from this particular topic. Okay, Environmental Protection Act, I have already given you information that one question is highly expected from this part. Okay, mitigation strategies, just one reading would be enough. But this should be studied, National Action Plan on Climate Change. And after that, this is the last part or the last topic of the syllabus. This is people and development. So two topics are still left. Then there is Kyoto Protocol in the environment. Number of times the question from Kyoto Protocol and Paris Agreement and International Solar Alliances has been asked. You have to study this. You cannot skip. One question is highly expected. Okay, one reading would be enough for this part. This is international agreements and Rio summit is very important from international agreements. Okay, Montreal has not been asked much of the times. Okay, but it doesn't mean that you can completely skip it. You have to go through from the basic knowledge about Montreal Protocol. Okay, this is the last one. This also contained polity, although this was changed in the from the syllabus from 2019 July. Okay, but still the questions from the polity are being put from this part. Okay, this is named as a higher education system, and this is asking about institution of a higher learning. Okay, these institutions are those which are registered under the UGC. This is University Grant Commission. They can ask you how many universities are recognized, how many are state universities, how many are central universities. These kind of things are put in the examination. Then evolution of a higher learning. Just one reading would be enough for covering this part. Okay. Then Oriental conventional, non-conventional learning programs in India. This is very important topic you have to go through. There are some of the there have been some of the government initiatives you have to go through for making the learning programs better in India. And after that, here is professional technical skill based education. One reading would be enough for this part, this particular part. Then value education and environmental education, one would be enough. This last part I would like to talk about. Okay. From this part, two questions are highly expected. The word policies and administration and governance has been written. Okay. That means whatever the different types of systems and the values given in the Constitution of India for the higher education system in India. Okay, higher education system in India. So you have to go through from this part, and two questions are highly expected. Okay, so if you go through from the basic knowledge and concept and terms about the higher education system in India, or from the constitution part, then you can expect your both two questions to be right. Okay. So in this way, I think this was the complete information. So in this proper video lecture, I have given you information regarding logical reasoning, then data interpretation, then ICT, people development and environment, then higher education. Let me make the conclusion of this video. That from teaching aptitude, four questions are expected. Research, you can make all the five right. Then from communication, five can be made right if you are very, very sound. Okay. I am telling about those students. When I tell five, five, four, some of the students should be thinking that, sir, are telling that almost you can get more than 80% marks. Let me tell you, this can be got. Number of my students have got, and I can show you the results as well. Okay. Because they were very much dedicated, and I expect each and every candidate to put 7 or 8 hours a day. And from that, you should spend at least 3 hours for the study of paper one. And from that 3 hours, 1.5 hour should be devoted solely for mathematical reasoning, then logical reasoning, then data interpretation. From logical reasoning, although 3 or 4 questions should be made right only, but from mathematical reasoning and data interpretation, 10 out of 10 marks can be got. Okay. Then from information technology, this is you just have to go through from the glossary and from individual items contained in the syllabus. From people and people development and environment, do not waste much of your time for some items given in the examination. Okay. Then from higher education system, must go from the polity and administration part. Okay. So now I have given you the information. Still, in case of any doubt or any query, you can ask us personally, or you can send me the message. So I make myself visible now. So I have given you information. So in this way, the paper one syllabus we have already covered. And now from the next video onwards, we shall start the specific chapters from paper one module. Okay. So each and everyone is expected to be regular, and you have to attempt the test series, and you have to attempt the daily tests given by me. And then you have to go through from the previous papers and whatever the explanation videos are given. Even if you are not a student of my paid badge, if you go through from the explanation videos daily, it shall give you very vast knowledge, so that number of your questions can be made right from the different modules. Okay. And in case you wish to join the regular batch for online classes that is going to be started from 21st of June, you can make confirmation personally to me. Okay. So now I leave, and tomorrow the lecture shall be for paper second only. Okay. So from Monday onwards, we shall start the specific topics from paper one, and regular classes will be taken. Thank you so much. This is Gurpal Singh from Gursar Education.